Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Today I'm here with my bi-weekly makeup drawer 6, but if you saw my last video, I did say that I was going to start making this into a monthly makeup drawer just because I have 3 different project pans going on right now, or they're not project pans, like one's a 1 month 2 palette, one's a pan that palette, and one is a project 60 pan. So because of that, I am going to be doing a monthly makeup drawer instead of a bi-weekly makeup drawer, but I'm just gonna still keep it like the part 6. I'm not gonna start over like part 1, so we're just gonna keep it like that. I am going to tell you right now that I don't have the lotion with me. It is the Bath & Body Works Stress Relief Lotion. I don't have it with me. It's somewhere else right now, but I did not use that, not once, these past 2 weeks. So yeah, sorry, I don't have that with me, but I mean, I didn't use it anyways. There's no progress to that. And I'm gonna go ahead and get into the face products, what I'm gonna be taking out, what I'm keeping in, what I am going to be adding in, and so forth. So let's begin this. There is a product that I did use up, and this is the Marcel Hydra C Energizing Hydrating Gel. This was just a sample. I used this up, so it's gonna be going out of this project. Not project, this makeup drawer. And then these things I'm gonna be taking out. This is the Porefessional License to Blot by Benefit, and this is the sample, and this is a sample of the Becca Backlight Priming Filter, just because I do have a primer that I am trying to use up. And then I also have the Becca Poreless Priming Perfector in a sample size. So, and that probably still has a ways to go. So for that reason, I'm gonna be taking these out. But I really did like this. This is so beautiful on the skin. I really like it, even though I'm oily. Yes, and then I have not even used this yet. Some more things I'm gonna be taking out is this blushing stick. And again, I don't know the name of this, but this is in the color Shy Pink. I did use quite a bit of this, and I really do like this for it being a cream product, which I usually don't like. So yeah, that was a surprise to me because it is quite pretty. I have it on today with another blush, but this is just going to be going up for now. This Lorac Natural Performance Foundation I really do like, and I might actually repurchase this because it is on sale for $18, or at least was on sale for $18 at Ulta, because I really do like it. And yeah, I'm just going to be putting it for now because I have a foundation that's already in my project pan, and I do want to go use some other foundations in my collection. The two highlighters that I have that I'm going to be putting up is the Essence Pure Nude highlighter, and this is very pretty. It is very subtle, but it is very pretty. And then the Wet n Wild Fergie, almost dropped that, the Rose Champagne Glow, which again is very pretty. I like them both, and I enjoyed using them. So yeah, I'm just gonna be putting these up for right now. The Balm Semi Luminizer, I really like this. Like, I didn't expect to like this so much than what I do. And I mean, it's been a while since I've used this, but I liked it before and I liked it now. But yeah, I'm just gonna be putting this up for now. And then I'm also gonna be putting up, these were the powders that I just kept in my makeup drawer no matter what, because like I said, these were my favorite powders. And if I had like a foundation that was too dark, I would use one. And if I had a foundation too light, I would use one. But right now I have a powder that's in my Project 60 pan. So to not be tempted, I'm just gonna go ahead and put these away. This is the Laura Geller Baked Balance and Brighten Foundation in Fair. And this is one of my favorites. As well as the Rimmel Stay Matte Powder. And this is in 03 Natural. I don't even know, because it's focusing on my face, that you'll be able to see these. Also, the Coty Airspun, it's in a Rimmel packaging, but I just press it into this, and I use this for like baking or like setting under my eye. So I'm just gonna be putting that up as well. And then the last things are the bronzers, contours, and under eye shades, or under eye shades, under eye powders. And this is the Butter Bronzer by Physicians Formula. I really like this, but I mean, I wouldn't say this is like my favorite bronzer, but I really do like it. I enjoyed using it, and I like the smell of it as well. I also really love the Wet n Wild's Mega Glow Contouring Palette. Yes, and then I have both of them. I have the Dolce de Leche and the Caramel Toffee. I would say the Dolce de Leche is my favorite one, just because the under eye is like matches me way better, and then this right here is not as orange as this one. And I'll show you. Not orange, not as dark as this one, and it is a tad bit orangish. So yeah, I did like this one better, but I really like both of them. The things that I'm going to be keeping in my drawer is the NYX HD Concealer in 03, which is light, and then the Avon Extra Lasting Concealer in fair. Like I said, I do want to use these up, so they're going to be staying in until they are used up. I have two foundations here. One I want to try and use, because I've never used none of these actually. One is the e.l.f. Flawless Finish Foundation, and this is in sand. This is a tad bit darker than my skin tone, but I think I can make it work. But this one will not work because it's just way too dark. It is the Extra Lasting Avon Liquid Foundation, and this is in natural beige. These, again, like I said, I've never used any of them, but I'm just going to go ahead and give this one away because this one will not work because it is too dark for my skin tone. I'm going to be adding in this Beauty For Real, what is this called? The Cream Blush and Illuminizer. It's called the Blush and Glow. This has like a blush on one side right here. And I'll swatch it for you. These I've never used, so that's why I just want to try these out as well. And it's right there, because I did like the other one surprisingly, so I want to see if these, if I'll like. And this is in High Beam, which is a highlighter. And I will swatch that for you. And it's, you probably won't even see it. It's like right next to it. But yeah, I want to just play with these for the month and see how I like this. I'm also adding in three highlighters because I'm extra like that. But you know, I have a month, so I decided to get, you know, some multiple highlighters just so I can have something and I won't get bored. The first one is the e.l.f. Baked Highlighter in Moonlight Pearls. And I'll swatch these for you, but I don't even know if you'll be able to see these, to be honest with you. That one's so pretty. It is right there. And then I also have the e.l.f. Blush in Gotta Glow. Which is right there. I also have this vintage one we got in our BoxyCharm in January, so I want to try this out. And this is what it looks like, and it comes in two shades. It comes with Rose Quartz and Chocolate Diamonds. Oh my gosh, they're so smooth. I've never used these, of course, because I just got them. Ooh, oh, yeah, very nice. Here's the Rose Quartz, and then the Chocolate Diamonds is next to it. That's very, very nice. I like that. My camera just shut me off. I don't know where we stopped, but I think I was talking about this. And this is the Estee Lauder Deluxe All Over Face Compact. And this has three blushes and a bronzer. This came with the Estee Lauder Deluxe Eyeshadow Compact that I'm actually panning right now. So yeah, I wanted to use this and get some love out of this just because it is quite old. And here's the shades right here. I swatched them previously because, you know, I thought I was recording, but I wasn't. So yeah, that's the shades right there. And the next thing I'm going to be adding in is the Anastasia Contour Kit. I think this is the light to medium. It's like the original one. But I'm going to be using this for my under eyes and for my contours and bronzing. So yeah, I'm going to add this. This was my very first like contouring palette. Yeah, so I'm going to be using that. And the last two things I'm going to be adding in for the face is this Air Repair Moisturizer and the Starvectin Concentrated Serum. Just because I don't really have time to do anything, much less, you know, moisturize my face. Which, you know, I should take the time, but I'm lucky to even wash my face off at night. So yeah, this right here is just, I'm going to be adding in so it's more handy because I don't come in my makeup room every night, and this right here stays in the living room. So yeah, I thought maybe if I have this in there that I would actually start using them. So yeah, I'm adding these in there as well. All right guys, now on to the sample perfumes that I wanted to use up. This one is a Simply Pink by Pink Sugar, and I used all this up, so that's gone. This one, I do not like the smell of this. And I tried using it, I'm like right here right now, so yeah, I just can't do it. This is from the Harvey Prince, and like, I don't know how to say this, the Damask Rose. I can't do that, so that one is just going. And I have not touched the Live Joyously yet. So yeah, I'm adding in 4 more little samples, but one of them I'm gonna count as one, or count as one, they are technically one. This is Flower Bomb, and one's like right here, and the one's down here. I think they're the same thing, if I'm not mistaken. I mean, they could be. No, I think they're 2 different things. Never mind. But anyways, because one's like a yellow tint and one's just clear. So I don't know. This one could be the Chanel one that I got a sample from Dillard's. So yeah. Anyways, these I'm just going to try and use. And this Modern Muse by Estee Lauder. And then this Daisy one, Marc Jacobs, which I have a ton of the Marc Jacobs ones. And I really do like them, so I don't mind using those. So I'm going to be trying to use these up as well during the month. Now I am proud to say that I finished the Avon Eyebrow Pencil in Universal. I mean, it's so small, like I couldn't even sharpen anymore. Like, I don't even know if you can see how small it is. It's just really, really small. Thank God that's done with, just because it was so waxy and I didn't enjoy using it anymore. So yeah, glad that this is gone. And since that is gone, sorry, that actually just dropped. I have been using the NYX Micro Brow Pencil, and I'm actually going to use this up as well because I don't have very much left of this at all. Like, I don't even know if you'll be able to see because my head's like ginormous and you can't see anything, but that's like all I have is just a little bitty tip left. I don't even know if you saw that. I'm sorry if you didn't. But yeah, I'm just gonna keep this in here until I use it up. I really enjoy it. And I am definitely going to be repurchasing this. The things that I'm going to be keeping in my bi-weekly makeup drawer, because I love them so much, is the Soap & Glory A Great Kisser Lip Moisturizing Balm in Juicy Peach. I've been loving this, and it's been helping with my dry lips, so I am going to keep that in there for another month. And then the Mica Beauty Cosmetics Eye Primer. And the reason why I want to keep this in is because this is one of my older eye primers, but it also works really well with that Urban Decay Primer Potion that is in my Project 60 pan. So for that reason, they're both going to stay in there for another month. The lip liners I'm going to be taking out is the Rimmel Exaggerant and Easton Snob. Also the Ivy or IBY Beauty in Deep Red. This is going to be going out as well. And this last one is the ColourPop Lippy Pencil. And this was supposed to be Taurus, but I grabbed the wrong one. So this is actually Tootsie. And that's probably why it was such a big difference to the actual Taurus Lippy Stick. And yeah, I'm just going to be taking this out as well. I'm going to be taking out the Lorac Tantalizer and Marco. This is so beautiful. I've been enjoying this very, very much. If not with what I'm wearing right now, which is the Taurus Lippy Stick with this on top, or just by itself, it's so, so beautiful. I love this. And because I know that I love it, I'm going to be putting it up and trying other like lipsticks and lip products I don't know if I like or not. Just, you know, see what I can get rid of, because I don't want to hoard everything. So I'm going to put that up for now. And the other one I really do love for just putting on, not like over anything, because it feels so good and it looks so pretty. And this is the Urban Decay Lip Junkie in Obsessed. I really enjoyed this one as well. I'm going to be putting up the NYX Butter Gloss and Strawberry Parfait. And the Tarte Charmed Lip Surgeons. as well as the Rihanna Viva Glam 1 lipstick, which I really, really, really enjoyed this. It has like a slight metallic-y look to it. I love it, and I really enjoyed that. Now, the lip products I'm going to be keeping in is products that I'm just unsure about, so I do want to use them some more and see how I feel about them. This one right here, the Laura Geller Love Me Dewy Lip Crayon in Happy Full. I didn't use this in the past 2 weeks because it is such a bright color. I just don't know how I feel about this. So I'm just going to try it out a little bit more if I actually try it out. The other one is the Lorac Siren. Oh, I just like smashed that into the lid. Great. This one right here, it is a pretty color, but I used it with the Lorac Royal Red lip gloss, and I really liked the way it looked, but it did like get on my teeth a lot, so I didn't know if it was from the lip gloss or the actual lipstick, and I did wipe off the lip gloss and it still did it, so I want to try it, like separate, and then try this separate and see which one it was, because that was not a pretty look, and yeah, I did like the color, just not that. And then this one right here, this is the LA Girl Glazed Lip Paint in Blushing. I don't know. The fact that I don't like how it applies, you have to get like a lip pencil or lip brush to actually apply it. And I don't know if I like the colors, so I don't know. I just want to like play with this a little bit more and see how I actually like that. Because these I'm just so unsure about. And I just want to have another month just to see if I like them, if I don't, get rid of them, Don't want to keep them in my collection to hoard when people can be loving them. Now, the stuff that I'm going to be adding in, and there is a lot I'm going to be adding in, but I figure since I have a month, I do want to try as many lip products as I can. Well, not as many as I can, just like, I want to try a variety of them. So I'm going to be adding in 2 of the Starlux lip liners, one's in Stellar and one's in Charm, like the BoxyCharm and Starlux collab. And this is what this one looks like. Oh my gosh, so hard. Are you serious? Oh, you guys, I don't know if I'm gonna like this one. That one is like hard. I don't know. And then this one is in Stellar. See, this one's like smooth compared to that other one. Oh my gosh, maybe I just have to warm it up. I don't know. All right. And that's what they look like. This one over here is the, right there is the BoxyCharm one. And then this one is the Stellar one. I have one red one that I'm adding in because I took the red out. And this is the NYX High Voltage lipstick. And this is in 20, which I don't know if it has a name. Yeah, Burlesque. And this one, I mean, I like the color of it, but I want to see how it wears. So yeah, I'm adding that one in as well. Now, I'm not adding in an actual pink, but this one's like a mauve-ish color, and it sort of looks pinkish to me. I don't know. This is in Jordana Modern Matte Lipstick and Matte Classy. So, I'll swatch that for you. There's that one right there. And to use with that, I'm going to use the Manic Adar Lip Lock Priming Lip Stain. And this is in the shade Lucky, which it seems very pigmented. Looks really pretty. And that's right next to it. And then for my like my neutral lip, I have 2. I have this one. This is the Bite Beauty and Glace. I think this was like last year's limited edition lipstick for Christmas. So pretty. It's right there, or 2 years ago. Could have been 2 years ago, to be honest. I don't know. I've had it for a while. And to go on top of that is the Lorac Lip Luster Cream and Empress, which I used to use this thing all the time. I love it. And that is right there. And the last thing is the NYX Intense Butter Gloss in Dos Leches. And this, I'm not gonna lie, it kind of like scares me to use this just because it's a lip gloss, but it's so pigmented. where you wouldn't have to like use anything, and I wouldn't use anything with it except for a lip liner. So that kind of freaks me out because I don't want it to bleed or like smear. So yeah, I'm gonna try this out to see how I like that. It is very pretty, but I just don't know how it'll look like on the lips because I've never used it. I've swatched it multiple times. I just never used it. Now this part I think is kind of excessive, but I'm going to be using the Ofra liquid lipstick in Napa Valley, and this is what we got in our BoxyCharm. And since it's like winter, I still think we can use this. Maybe I'm going to use it. So yeah, I just want to use it. It's so pretty. It's like a metallic purple. I'm excited to use that right there. And I'm also going to be using this Camellia Cosmetics in 23, which is like a purpley red color. I will swatch that for you. Oh my goodness, that's actually a lot lighter than what I thought it was going to be. Oh my goodness, that's a lot like lighter and pinker than what I thought it was going to be. Anywho, we'll just try it out. And for lip glosses, because I only have like 3 lip glosses that are purple, I want to like try these out to see what I like better with each. So the first one is the Urban Decay Lip Junkie in Love Junkie. And I like the formula of this, I already know. So yeah, this one's like actually much sheer than what I thought it was gonna be. Right there, which is actually really pretty. And then this one is the Lorac in Rockstar. Oh, that's actually, you can barely see that. Are you kidding me? Like these don't show up at all what they look like in here, but that you can't even see it. It's like basically clear with just a tad bit tint of purple. And then this is the Urban Decay in Bittersweet, and this is like a little sample of the lip gloss. There we go. See, now that's what I was expecting. Now that's kind of pretty. And that's right there. So yeah, that's all that is in my monthly makeup drawer for this month. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. And until next time, thank you. Bye.